Assembled Congress hears the President and his promise to all people fighting aggression.
We shall send you in ever-increasing numbers, ships, planes, tanks, guns. That is our purpose and our pledge.
And the President's words meant action as billions of dollars worth of goods start to flow to embattled England and other allied countries. America became the arsenal of democracy. We're in the war now, but all through 1941, we were in there on the side of democracy. Unprecedented in the annals of the United States was the inauguration of Mr. Roosevelt to his third term. He took office to face the most critical period of our nation's history. During the year, up to the day we entered the war, sabotage and strikes were rife in the country. Some acts were proven deliberate, some were not, but thousands upon thousands of man hours were lost. Under international law, the United States seized Axis ships in our ports. This was to prevent the sabotage of these vessels. It took the war to unite our people, to unite capital and labor. Strikes flared again and again throughout the nation, accompanied by violence and bloodshed. But now, scenes such as these are a thing of the past, for this nation will make a supreme effort to back our armed forces with the weapons they need. This is everybody's war. We're all in this war for victory.